In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Merciful and compassionate Father, we confess our sins, and we humbly come to you to find forgiveness and life. We come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 virus that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love, and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Bless our efforts to use the medicines developed to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for the health workers, that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted, may they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen. Our Lady Health of the Sick, pray for us. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Saint Raphael the Archangel, pray for us. San Roque, pray for us. San Lorenzo Ruiz, pray for us. San Pedro Calungsod, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Welcome, brothers and sisters in Christ, to the celebration of the Holy Eucharist. We are the 29th Sunday in Ordinary Time, and we also celebrate Sunday for Cultures. Our priest presider is the Reverend Father Mario Sobrejuanite of the Society of St. Paul. He is the spiritual director of the Acts Catholic Prayer Community and is currently assigned at the Divine Master Retreat House in Ariccia, Italy. Let us join the Acts minstrels in singing the entrance hymn.
Once again gather as church, Kyriake Oikia, beautifully translated as the family of God. We come before our Father who knows our needs even before we approach Him. We begin then with faith in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Today's readings remind us to persevere in prayer and not to lose heart amidst all the difficulties of life. Thus, let us ask the Lord the grace to overcome suffering in love and truth. As we celebrate Sunday for Cultures, we pray for openness towards dialogue to all the cultures we encounter. We also pray for all cultural workers that they may reflect God's splendor in their life and in their work. Asking now God's forgiveness and an increase of faith for the times we forgot that He is a loving Father for us, we ask for mercy and grace. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Almighty ever-living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. The outstretched hands of Moses during the Israelites' battle against the Amalekites assure Israel's victory, illustrating the power of prayer. The first reading.
A reading from the book of Exodus. In those days, Amalek came and waged war against Israel. Moses therefore said to Joshua, pick out certain men, and tomorrow go out and engage Amalek in battle. I will be standing on top of the hill with the staff of God in my hand. So Joshua did as Moses told him. He engaged Amalek in battle after Moses had climbed to the top of the hill with Aaron and Hur. As long as Moses kept his hands raised up, Israel had the better of the fight. But when he let his hands rest, Amalek had the better of the fight. Moses' hands, however, grew tired, so they put a rock in place for him to sit on. Meanwhile, Aaron and Hur supported his hands, one on one side and one on the other, so that his hands remained steady, till sunset. And Joshua mowed down Amalek and his people with the edge of the sword. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Apostle Paul asks Timothy to remain faithful to the teachings of Christ and to equip ourselves for good work through our recourse to the scriptures. As Christians, we are called to do the same. The second reading.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, remain faithful to what you have learned and believed, because you know from whom you learned it, and that from infancy you have known the sacred scriptures, which are capable of giving you wisdom for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. All scripture is inspired by God and is useful for teaching, for refutation, for correction, and for training in righteousness, so that one who belongs to God may be competent, equipped for every good work. I charge you in the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who will judge the living and the dead, and by his appearing and his kingly power, proclaim the word. Be persistent, whether it is convenient or inconvenient. Convince, reprimand, encourage through all patience and teaching. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let us give glory and honor to the Holy Gospel. The word of God is living and effective, discerning reflections and thoughts of the heart. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus told his disciples a parable about the necessity for them to pray always without becoming weary. He said, there was a judge in a certain town who neither feared God nor respected any human being. And a widow in that town used to come to him and say, render a just decision for me against my adversary. For a long time, the judge was unwilling, but eventually thought, while it is true that I neither fear God nor respect any human being, because this widow keeps bothering me, I shall deliver a just decision for her, lest she finally come and strike me. The Lord said, pay attention to what the dishonest judge says. Will not God then secure the rights of his chosen ones, who call out to him day and night? Will he be slow to answer them? I tell you, he will see to it that justice is done for them speedily. But when the Son of Man comes, will he find faith on earth? Sisters and brothers, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord uses a lot of parables, and many say they are allegories na tutungkol sa buhay, kwento, bahagi, aparte ng buhay. But more than just being mere allegories, they are meant to provoke us, to make us think, to go deeper into the truths of our lives, and to go into the teaching of Jesus and find out what is it that God desires of us. Kadalasan na-exaggerate, but the Lord wants us to understand the situations so that we can draw many things from the teachings that He gave. Ang ating po ngayong protagonist is a widow. Pag sinabi mong widow, bibigyan natin ng kunting background. Yan ang isa sa mga lugi sa society ng mga Hudyo noong panahon ni Jesus. Una, sapagkat babae ka. You are a second class citizen. Pero pag ikay naging widow, you lose everything. Because ang babae has no legal personality. Dahil wala siyang legal personality, has to depend on a man, either a husband or a son, to be able to represent him in the court. Kaya itong widow, una, wala na siyang civil rights, wala na siyang social rights. He has no one to lean on for support. Definitely, sigurado tayo, he has no money to make herself count before these judges. In short, sa tingin ng iba, ang widow ay isang alagain, problema, pasanin sa kanilang lipunan. And this widow is asking for justice. dinidescribe sa atin ngayon kung ano yung judge. Wala siyang pakialam sa tao. He does not respect God. He does not respect any other human being. He will decide according to his decisions. Dito naman ipapakita sa atin ni Lucas yung qualities na itong babaeng ito. Her tenacity, her not being able to say, wala nang magagawa. She did not easily give up. She was insistent. She was persevering. She was giving it all. Why? Because she truly desired that justice. Another background, kaya ikinikwento to ni Lucas sa atin, is because Lucas, during his time, was telling this story to the Christians who were experiencing exactly all of these. At ano po yun? The Christians during the time were being expelled by the Jews from the synagogues. Not only that, they were being accused of a lot of things. They were being persecuted. They were being denounced. There was injustice that was being caused, that was being made on them. Some of them were being made martyrs, killed, made to suffer in torture. Kaya alam natin ngayon kung ano ang magiging reaksyon ng isang humihingi. And at that moment, Luke knew that the feeling of being abandoned, the feeling of a God that does not seem to respond to our needs, who seemingly is blind to our situation, who is deaf to the cries of his people, who seems to be so aloof and far and distant. Yun ang feeling na yun. Kaya ikinwento niya itong kanyang parable. As we focus on the woman's tenacity and insistence, makes us to focus now yung kanyang hinihingian. Because towards the end, Jesus would tell us, kung ito nga pinagbigyan, hindi dahil sa kung ano paman, kundi sapagkat nabibisit na siya, sapagkat naguguluhan na siya, sapagkat natatakot na siya na baka gumawa ng isang pamamaraang marahas ang babae, he decided, sige, pagbigyan na nga yan. And Lucas, towards the end, points to Jesus and saying, hindi ganun ang inyong Diyos na nilalapitan. Hindi lamang siya isang nagsasabing, ay, pagbigyan na yan, nabibisit na ako. He's telling us something else. Ang inyong kinakausap, ang inyong hinihingian, is a father who knows your needs even before you approach him. Is one who in the very beginning has only your good in his heart. And he will never do anything that in the end will hurt you because he has made you in his image and likeness. So ang focus ngayon is doon sa hinihingian. At ano po yun? Lucas is saying, then don't lose faith on this whom you are approaching. Do not let go of him. Do not seek for other solutions because all the solutions are to be found in him. So Lucas is telling us, be strong in him. Remain in him. Maintain your faith. Hold on to him. Do not give up on him. Do not lose him in your life. Because in the end, it is only he who truly desires your good and who in the end will grant you your heart's desire. Perseverance, tenacity, decision to stay strong and remain in your faith, to depend on this God because he will find the solution to your problem. Pero sasabihin ko na sa inyo sa totoo lang ha. Pag inipit mo ang Diyos, sasabihin, ito yung gagawin mo para sa akin. That is not prayer. That is not faith. That is telling God to do what you want. The best prayer pa rin is, alam mo yung nilalapitan mo. Alam mo ibibigay niya sa iyo. Sa tamang panahon, sa kung anong bagay sa iyo, kung may pananampalataya ka pa na sa puso mo. All of these will be given if you just continue to trust Him. You may not get what you wanted, but you will definitely get what you needed. So anong gospel message ngayon? Napakasimple. To be strong in your faith, to not let go of your God, to remain in prayer, humbly asking this God that you be answered according to His time. Sometimes the Lord talagang pinapayagan niya. Ako, na-notice ko to sa buhay ko. May mga pagkakataon na nagdi-demand ka. Itong gusto ko. And then towards the end, when say, sige nga Lord, ikaw na lang ang mag-decide. Ibibigay sa iyo. 6.5 years ago, nandito ako sa, pinadala ko rito ng ating, ng aming superior general. Kasi ang bahay daw, itong aming retreat house was in a very negative situation economically. At ang sabi niya ay, nagdi-decision na nga kami, buong members ng Pauline family, sapagkat this belongs to us, na ibenta na kasi 1.5 million halos ang idinadagdag para isuportahan ang bahay na ito so that it can continue. And towards the end, the generals, our big bosses were saying, hindi na kaya. Talagang ilalad ko na natin. We are bleeding. Umaayaw man yung iba, pero sabi nila, again. And then towards the end, tinawagan nga ako at ang sabi, pumunta ka nga rin, gawan mo ng paraan. I'll have to be honest with you, it is not easy to be placed as superior on top of all old Italians who were big ones during their times. Siyempre, nag-struggle ako 6.5 years, and towards the end, sabi ko, pagbibigyan kaya ako dito. I've been praying very hard, and I know it was, pumasok ko yung pandemic, parang napupostpone na sana'y mabigyan ako ng pagkakataon, makabalik na sa Pilipinas. Lalo na kasi, para namang sinwerte kami at na-bless kami. Napakagaling yung aking mga kasamahang mga Italianong dalawang brothers dito, that we were able in just 1 year turn around the economic situation. Kaya nag-request ako. And in his time, you know, according to what he desires, si Father Mario po'y pinapayagan ng bumalik sa Pilipinas. So by October 30, babalik na ako sa Pilipinas and I will be reintegrated to the Philippine community ng mga Society of St. Paul. So magkikita-kita po tayo roon. The thing is, do not insist na ngayon na. Do not insist na ito na. Ito ang dapat. Just tell the Lord, Lord, in your time, I will say yes. Pero alam mo naman, I'm not giving up on this prayer. To easily give up on Him, maghanap na ako ng ibang solusyon. Ayaw niya akong pakinggan. Hindi na ako pwedeng maniwala sa Kanya. To let go is one of the greatest mistakes we could ever make. And sometimes you need to be tenacious, persevering. Kapag kunwento natin kung wala lang tenacity ang maraming tao sa storya ng mundo, we will be losing a lot of real good discoveries. Ito lang bibigyan ko ng example. Si Thomas Edison invented the electric bulb. His greatest problem was yung filament sa loob ng bulb. Kasi pag oras na isinaksak niya, kaagad nasusunog. Kaagad hindi tumatagal. Kaagad, alam niya, hindi pwede ito. Do you know how many times he had tried? 9,999 times naghanap siya ng material, the filament that will not burn. Towards the end, may nagsabi na sa kanya, 9,999 ka na. Huwag mo sabihin alam, huwag mo sabihin paaabutin mo yan sa 10,000 bago ka magdesisyon. Ay, talagang hindi siya doable, impossible, hindi mangyayari ito. And towards the end, he decided, no, itinuloy niya and found the right filament for the electric bulb. Sabi sa kanya, lahat ng ginawa mo in the past, puro lahat mistakes yun. Ang ganda ng sagot niya, no, they were not mistakes. They were discoveries. I discovered yung lahat ng 9,999 were the wrong materials for the filament. Ang ganda nun. Yung concept, may solution eh. I'm not giving up. And at the end, he discovers and invents the electric bulb. When you believe in one thing, when you involve God in what you do, when what you see is important, when you are passionate about it, then you will get that tenacity that this woman was asking the judge to give in. To fight with all your energies, to believe that God will give you a hand, to believe that a solution is waiting And if God is with you, that solution will one day be achieved. To refuse no as the only answer, and to believe that totoo sa iyong mga kamay o pwede hindi mangyari, sa kamay ng Diyos, magagawa ng faith tells us not to give up. Faith tells us there is a solution. Faith tells us there is a way out. Faith tells us this can be resolved in one way or another. Faith tells us your God is a God of solution. It's easy to quit, mga kapatid. At yan ang i-insist ni Lucas kayo. Don't quit on your God. Don't quit on your faith. Just continue. Ito na, ikwento ko na ito minsan kasi napaganda palang story nito na hindi lahat siguro nakakaalam. There was one man who decided not to quit. At the age of 31, no? Dahil ang pamilya na'y napakahirap, ang nangyari they were forced out of their homes. In 1818, namatay ang nanay niya. In 1831, pumasok siya sa business, lugi ang negosyo. In 1832, he ran for the legislator, talo. In 1832, he lost his job. He wanted to get into law school. Hindi siya tinanggap. In 1833, he borrowed money from somebody. Lugi ang negosyo. And for the next 17 years of his life, he was paying this debt dahil sa negosyo na lugi. In 1835, he was engaged to be married. His sweetheart biglang namatay. He was heartbroken. Nagkaroon ng nervous breakdown. He was in bed for 6 months. In 1838, he wanted to be a speaker for the state. Talo. In 1840, he sought for the legislature to be part of the legislature to become elector. Talo. In 1843, he ran for Congress. Talo. In 1846, nanalo siya, but he wanted a re-election. Talo. In decided to have a job of the land officer in Congress. Talo. In 1854, he ran for the Senate. Talo. In 1856, he wanted to be nominated as vice president. Talo. In 1858, he decided to enter Senate. Talo. 8 times, talo. Did that tell him, give up? There is no way na mananalo ka. He decided to try. In 1860, he ran for president of the United States. And Abraham Lincoln won the presidency. Siguro kung ibang tao yun, matagal nang nag-give up. Not this guy. And they will turn out to be one of the most great presidents of the United States. I believe yung dinaanan niyang hirap made him to be stronger and made him, informed him to be what he should be as a president of a nation. May isa pa akong story ang nakuha. Ang ganda kasi ito. Isang Japanese general daw, si Nobunaga, was about to fight a battle where natataranta ang lahat ng kanyang mga kasama. Bakit? 1:10 ang labanan. The number of the soldiers of the enemy's side is 10 times greater than their numbers. And he was telling the soldiers, we will win. And of course, they doubted. The numbers tell them they will not win against so big a group, an enemy. And so on the way to the battle, Nobunaga decided that they should all go to a Shinto shrine. And he asked his soldiers to pray with him. And then he said, let's ask for a sign. Kung mananalo ba tayo o matatalo? At kumuha siya ng isang coin. Nagdasal na tayo. Ngayon, sasabihin natin dito sa ating Diyos, bigyan mo kami ng sign. Pag tinos ko ang coin at head ang lumabas, panalo tayo. Pag tinos ko ang coin at tail ang lumabas, talo tayo. And the soldiers wanted to for that sign. So he tossed the coin, bagsak, head. And Nobunaga told the soldiers, the gods have spoken, we will win the battle. That made the soldiers so excited, so this so willing to fight. They knew the gods have spoken. They are meant to win. And they did win the battle sa kabila ng numbers were sus, where their numbers were so small. The next day, yung assistant ng general lumapit sa sabi niya, General, tama ka. Nobody can change destiny once the gods have spoken. Ang sagot ng general, correctly. And then showed him the coin. Isang coin na special because that coin has both faces, heads. Nobunaga said, if you believe, it will happen. You don't need to toss a coin. We just have to increase our faith that in this God, when we persist in our prayer, paninindigan niya na siya'y ama at tayo kanyang mga anak na nangangailangan at in his time, according to his plans, according to his love, he will bring us, give us that which is truly best for us. Amen. And so we proclaim, I believe in one God.
The Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible, I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The prayer of the faithful. Almighty Father, through your Son's paschal mystery, you help us persevere in prayer and not lose heart. Empower and embolden our frail faith as we say, Loving Father, you are our strength and our hope.
Loving Father, you are our strength and our hope.
Loving Father, grant us, your church, holy perseverance as we strive to become a perfect mirror of your love and mercy in our charisms and apostolates. We pray.
Loving Father, you are our strength and our hope.
Loving Father, help our national and local leaders to not lose heart in what is true, good, and beautiful. Inspire them to see you in their countrymen, whom they have sworn to serve. We pray.
Loving Father, you are our strength and our hope.
Loving Father, make us more sensitive to the movement of your spirit in the different cultures we have an encounter. Sustain all cultural workers in their quest to make manifest your presence through the work that they do. We pray.
Loving Father, you are our strength and our hope.
Loving Father, may the 16th Jesus Encounter Seminar this month of October be truly an instrument to the people whom the Lord will send to establish and deepen their personal relationship with Jesus and begin to feel his presence and experience the Lord working in them and through them. We pray.
Loving Father, you are our strength and our hope.
Loving Father, continue to protect our viewers, the homebound and their families, and through the powerful intercession of our Blessed Mother, grant all intentions and requests offered through this Mass. We pray.
Loving Father, you are our strength and our hope.
Loving Father, open the gates of your heavenly communion to our departed loved ones, especially those who have tirelessly persevered for the greater glory of your kingdom. We pray.
Loving Father, you are our strength and our hope.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
Loving Father, you are our strength and our hope.
In a special manner, we'd like to pray for all of those who are sick, yung mga nilalapit sa atin dito sa ating misang ito. I pray personally also for someone close to us in our family, our sister Teresita, who has brain cancer, as we entrust her and all the sick to the mercy of God and to the healing intercession of Mary, our mother. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, you are our strength and our hope.
Your word, Father, is living and effective, discerning reflections and thoughts of the heart. Help us to make the right discernment and decision so that we may become more effective servants of your kingdom through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, my dear friends, that your sacrifice and mine be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant us, Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from an unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Full of your glory, O Son.
indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, with our cardinals and bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. We are addressing our prayer to not just a mere judge, but an omnipotent Father, a loving Father who knows our needs even before we approach him. We pray with Jesus, with the confidence of children, as we pray the Our Father.
Thy kingdom come.
Deliver us, O Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus the Christ.
For the kingdom.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Peace means we have suddenly come to the realization that we believe in a God who is Father, powerful and mighty, who truly loves us. Share the peace with one another. Peace be with you.
Peace be with you, Father, brothers and sisters.
Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who come to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Together, let us pray this prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you with thanks, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray that benefiting from participation in heavenly things, we may be helped by what you give in this present age and prepared for the gifts that are eternal through Christ our Lord.
Amen. We have some announcements. Tired of weak connections? Come and be connected with our Acts Zoom Jesus Encounter Seminar, or JES16. There will be 3 days. On the first day, will be on October 22, Saturday, from 9 a.m. to 12 noon. Why did we lose our connection to God? Our speaker is Father Mario Sobrejuanite of the Society of St. Paul. Day 2, October 25, Tuesday, 7:30 to 9:30 p.m., Who Restored Our Connection? Speaker, Brother Obet Cabrillas. On day 3, October 27, Thursday, 7:30 to 9:30 p.m., How Can We Stay Connected to God? Father Domi Guzman of the Society of St. Paul is a speaker. On the last day, October 29, Saturday, 2 to 4:30 p.m., What Strengthens Our Connection? By Brother Vic Pestanio. All individuals aged 18 years and older are welcome to join our ACT Zoom JES, Jesus Encounter Seminar. Interested parties may send a private message to our FB page at actsprayer.com. Thank you.
Sa dami ng problema ang ating hinaharap, maybe we should find again the reason why are these things happening and the God behind it all who is still in control. So kung feeling po ninyo you want answers, maybe this seminar will be able to give you some answers. We continue to pray for all of those who are asking for prayers at pinapadalan po kami ng kanilang mga comments at ang kanilang mga tulong din at ang kanilang mga intentions. We are joining you in praying for all of those intentions before our God who desires that we do not lose faith in Him, that we do not let go of Him, that we hold unto Him, because He is a loving Father. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the blessing of Almighty God continue to be on you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Go in the peace and love of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You, Lord. Lord.